sampling our weather, looking at the data, it's still pointing toward a very warm day, a very windy day as well, but it still looks like it's going to be dry for the parade. But we were talking about a chance of showers after sundown, and that still may happen for those who are going to celebrate long hours. Here's Stormview Doppler radar zooming it up to the north. St. Joseph spotter training talk from the National Weather Service for Buchanan County. Word of Life Church, there's the address, 3902 Northeast Riverside Road, free and open to the public. About 90 minutes of good info for you and your family. City View camera, it's shaking. It's wobbling, mainly because it's been so windy all day today. We have 68 degrees, 42% humidity, south winds at 18 miles an hour. The trouble is the winds are going to be even stronger during the daytime hours tomorrow. Weather watchers, Rich Hill at 69 degrees, Peculiar the same, Olathe 68, so way above average for this time of year since we should be stopping in the lower 50s for a high. Looks like these clouds are not stopping their progress to the east. We have clear skies farther down 50 Highway, down towards Sedalia, even going toward the Lake of the Ozarks. But it's a partly cloudy mix for Hiawatha, St. Joe, and back toward Lawrence. We'll be shrouded in this cloudiness as well, but it's not going to last very long. It's a very thin band. Some more cloudiness also across Nebraska. Not going to give us precipitation tonight, so if you are heading out, partly to mostly sunny skies, temperatures in the 50s, it will be refreshing. Cookout. Well, if you're thinking about it, because the soil is still kind of damp in most areas, I don't think we have an elevated fire danger, but it's going to be very difficult to keep the fire going on the pilot or the coals going because it is so breezy, so keep that in mind. But it will be a pleasant night even just to sit out and look at the stars for a while. Overnight lows, crystal clear temperature-wise. 48 in Maryville, 50 for St. Joe, 56 degrees in Belton, and down to Clinton, 56 degrees. And these temperatures are closer to what we should have during the daytime. So if we're starting off that far ahead of schedule during the night, you know tomorrow afternoon we're going to be a lot warmer than that for sure. So the milder air will be lasting into the daytime hours on Thursday too. We do have our high pressure area, which is now releasing its grip slowly but surely, still over the boot heel of Missouri. Clockwise circulation is why we have those southerly winds. And the space between the low and the high is squeezing the air, which is why we've had the gusty breezes all day today. This is what's going to possibly tap off a couple of showers during the evening hours on Thursday, but it looks like they'll be after the parade. So if we have to have any rain, why don't we have it at that time for sure? And then farther to the southwest we look, and then also from there to the Pacific Northwest, and that's where we see better chances of rain that will be falling. Look at this stripe of pretty active weather that's moving through the Intermountain region. This is why the weekend looks fairly unsettled. A series of storm systems will try to line up one after the other, giving us an increasing chance of rain for the weekend. But let's go back to Thursday, shall we? Here's what we see coming for us. We'll stop it at about kickoff time for the parade. Sunshine aplenty. The front tries to make advances toward this region. Looks like future scans picking up on a stray shower after, say, 9 or 10 o'clock at night, then through the pre-dawn. Very light. Not everybody's going to see it. So your timeline goes something like this. 60 in the morning, 71 for the parade, strong south winds, which will make it very challenging for the balloon handlers. 79 are high. And then between 5 and about 12 o'clock is when I think the winds will shift. That's when you can see that slight chance of a shower moving through. So keep that in mind. Here's your 7-day forecast. Very warm for the luck of the Irish as we go to near 80 degrees. Not a record. We have to be a couple degrees warmer than that, but most of the day is looking on the dry side. As we go into Friday, cooler weather behind that system, 52 to 63 degrees then. Saturday and Sunday have chances of rain. We go back into the 60s on Sunday. Monday and Tuesday, we back into the 70s with a chance of some showers and thunderstorms too. And then it cools back down 48 to 60 degrees. And some of the storms on Monday and Tuesday look like they could be a little strong, something we'll continue to monitor here in the First Alert Weather Center. But I know that Grand Marshal Mahoney is happy to hear about that forecast.
Pretty darn nice tomorrow.
But the balloons, I don't know if that's too windy for them. We'll see.
80 degrees. Wow, that's good, though. That's really good.